Namah Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine. Hare Krishna everyone. So welcome back to part 2 of the Demon series. So in video 1, we talked about Putana and how Putana represents the anartha called Mithya Guru, the external and internal. So now Krishna was 8 days old when Putana appeared and Krishna killed her. When Krishna became 3 months, there was a momentous event. So Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj had a nice festival organized, and what was the festival about? It was called Uttana Utsav, Uttana Samskara. Our little baby Krishna, he turned 3 months old, and at 3 months he started turning. Uttana, to get up, not necessarily to walk, but he would just get up, move his body, and he would change sides. How wonderful our Vedic culture is, that every momentous thing is celebrated, noted, it's so prominent. So Mother Yashoda, she had so many guests come and Brahmanas were there, she had to take care of so many festivities. So she, what did she do? She put this baby Krishna under an old cart, and on top of that cart there were a lot of this unused items, old items, and underneath that Krishna was happily sleeping. So while she was taking care of the guests and festivities, Krishna woke up and he was really hungry and he needed to be fed milk. He tried to get the attention of his mother, but then his mother was busy with so many things, and now he was getting a little angry, and he somehow or other wanted to get the attention of his mother. And now the speciality of this cart is that there was a demon who was also present in that cart, the cart demon Shakatasura. Who was this Shakatasura in his previous life? He was the son of Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu's brother, if you remember. So Hiranyaksha's son was called Utkacha. So this Shakatasura was Utkacha in his previous life, and he had a heavy body, and with that heavy body he would stomp his feet all over the place, and wherever he went he created a ruckus. He would uproot the trees and create a mess wherever he went. And on one such destructive expeditions of his, Lomaharsha Muni was so annoyed with his behavior that he cursed this Utkacha, saying that your heavy body should become very light body in the next life. And when he cursed like this, this Utkacha became Shakatasura, and now his body was so light, just like air, that he could take anywhere, any form. And when Kamsa sent Shakatasura for killing Krishna, Shakatasura came and he became part of this cart. And now the cart was so heavy, although he was in the form of air. And Krishna, he was here trying to, you know, look for his mother. He's feeling so hungry and angry at the same time that his mother is not giving him the due attention to him. He looked here, looked there, and then finally he lifted one of his feet and kicked the cart. The moment he kicked the cart, all those old items that were kept on the cart fell down, and there was this tumultuous noise. Shakatasura also died because of that hard kick from this baby Krishna. And then all these gopis and gopas, including Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, came running thinking, what happened to our little boy Krishna? And then they say, oh, see all these utensils fallen down, scattered, helter and skelter. And then some of these little boys, Gopabalas, they said that, oh, actually it was this baby Krishna who kicked this cart, and that is what created all this. But Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mata, they are so filled with Vatsalya Rasa for Krishna that no matter who says what, and no matter what wonderful things, unimaginable things Krishna does, for them he is just their baby boy. So they just brush off these statements made by the Gopabalas, and they are just like Mother Yashoda immediately picks up Krishna and makes sure he's okay and he's not hurt, and he calls for Brahmana, and then again those things, you know, bring the cow urine and clean him up and tell all the Raksha mantras and do all those things. But this time, along with these things, she also took Krishna on her lap and started feeding him milk. So now this Shakatasura, which anartha does he represent? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Shakatasura represents all our old bad habits. And not only our old bad habits, it's our load carrying mentality. Just like the cart carries load, here the anartha represents is our load carrying mentality. So when we start our Krishna consciousness life, there are so many bad habits, knowingly, unknowingly, wantingly, unwantingly, so many things we bring with us. And all these are unnecessary. In fact, they are hindrance. That is why they are called anarthas. They are hindering us. All our old bad habits are hindering us, holding us back from going further and making progress in spirituality. And also this load carrying mentality means carrying a lot of unnecessary material load. Oh, I am the breadwinner of the family. I am the one who is taking care of my family. I am carrying the load of my family. Go to the office. I am heading this project. I am heading this team. I am heading this unit. I am the CEO. I am the president. I am the owner. I am this. I am that. Without me, nothing will happen here. Everybody is waiting for at my beck and call for my instructions. Load carrying mentality in the profession, in the community. I am the community president, I am associate, I am this, I am that, I am organizing community events, I am helping in the water problem, this problem, that problem in my community. At the national level, load carrying, like I am doing so much for my nation, I am contributing this, I am sacrificing this, I am doing, I am doing, I am irreplaceable. If I am there, nothing is going to happen. This kind of a material load carrying mentality, this anartha is holding us back from progressing in Krishna consciousness. So we should become very aware of this. So we should keep our material load as minimal as possible, and even that whatever little minimal thing is there, we should divert that also as a service to Krishna. The only load worth carrying in this material world is the service towards the spiritual, the service towards the Supreme Lord and also towards our Guru. Other than that, any other material load we are carrying, absolutely unnecessary. It is simply an anartha. So just like my Guru Srila Prabhupada, he beautifully narrates this small story. That there was this old woman, very fragile, very weak. She was carrying a bundle of wood on her head through the forest, coming back to her home. But somehow, while she was heading back home through the jungle, she stumbled upon a stone and this entire bundle of wood that she was carrying upon her head fell down. And then she was so miserable that she needed somebody's help to put that bundle of wood back on her head. And who will she find in the jungle? Hardly anybody. So she started praying intensely to the Lord, saying that, "Oh Lord, please help me, help me, help me." Because she called out with such ardrata, with such earnestness, the Supreme Lord himself appeared and said, "Mother, how can I help you? What can I do for you?" And of all the things that this old woman could have asked the Supreme Lord for, can you guess what she asked? All she said was, "Oh, look at this bundle of woods. It's fallen down and there is nobody to put it back on my head. So could you kindly, please, put this bundle of woods back on my head?" And then the Lord obliged and put the bundle of wood back on her head and she carried it home. So we are like that, the foolish old woman, like she could have asked for so many things. Likewise, when we go to the Supreme Lord, The only Lord we should be asking for is, Lord, how can I serve you? Lord, how can you please kindly engage me in your service? But instead, what do we ask him for? Just like that old woman, utterly foolish. My office problem, my relationship problem, money problem, children problem, wife problem, health problems. Oh, many problems. Load, 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 load. Put it back on my head. Foolish. Utterly foolish. And it's an anartha. We should become very aware of this. So we should make it a point to unload all this unnecessary load. And the only load we should take upon our heads is, how can I serve the Lord and my spiritual master? And this is represented by the cart demon Shakatasura. So all the old habits, the load carrying mentality, and third, Shakatasura also represents lethargy, laziness. So we should overcome this hindrance, the hindering block, laziness on our path of spirituality to make quick progress. In fact, Krishna himself in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 3, verse number 30, he says, to Arjuna, he tells Arjuna, Mai sarvani karmani sanyasya dhyatma chetasa nirashir nirmamo bhutva yudhyasva vigatajvaraha. Krishna is encouraging Arjuna, Mai sarvani karmani, all your karmas, sanyasya dhyatma chetasa, be conscious of me and give them up to me. Nirashir nirmamo bhutva, don't have this sense of doership that I am the doer. No, you are not. And then yudhyasva, and don't think you can just like that give up fighting, give up your duty and go somewhere to the forest and meditate. No, you should fight. But how should you fight? As a matter of duty. And also how should you fight? As a way of serving me, pleasing me. Vigata jvaraha. So Krishna is telling, give up this lethargy, Arjuna. It doesn't befit a kshatriya like you. Get up and fight. So likewise, we should also give up our lethargy in our spirituality, and any service that comes our way, be willing to do it and do it wholeheartedly. And also we should be cautious. Now, how do we overcome these anarthas? So the load mentality, I already told you, we should be very conscious to pick up the load only as much as is needed for serving the Lord. And also we should be very aware that we should not think, okay, if I'm smoking gradually, instead of 10 cigarettes a day, I will start smoking 8 cigarettes, then 6 cigarettes, 4 cigarettes, then finally. No, this gradual mentality we should overcome. It should be a revolution. If something is bad, I have to give it up like that immediately. And how do I do that? Pick yourself away and place yourself in another situation where that thing which is enticing you, pulling you back into those bad habits, don't even be there. Like if somebody is addicted to watching TV, if you're going to sit in your living area with a big sized flat screen TV, you are going to be enticed to watching it. If your other family members are switching on watching, obviously even you will want to watch. But if you go off to Vrindavan or somewhere for 1 month where there is no TV, no access to nothing. So remove yourself from the situation, from the association where you will be pulled into those bad habits. And it should happen immediately, not gradually. So it should be a revolutionary shift, not a gradual shift. And about the laziness, identify what is it that you feel lazy about and do that very thing, whether you like it or you don't like it. Like sometimes we ask our, the people who are coming into Krishna consciousness, taking up spirituality, we tell them, have you been chanting your rounds? They're honest, but then they say, no, I don't feel like doing it. Well, who told you that you should feel like doing it in order to chant? Do you think we feel like it every day? No, we don't. The thing is, when you know this is the right thing to do, whether you feel like it, you don't feel like it, whether you like it, you don't like it, you just do it. Like Nike's adage, right? Just do it. So don't fall into this trap of Maya that I don't feel like it. It doesn't matter. You should anyway do it. So this is Shakatasura, the cart demon, who he was in his previous life and what anartha he represents and how we can overcome. And then going forward, Krishna, from 3 months old baby, he kept growing up very nicely. And it was his first Janmashtami, the first birthday, appearance day of Krishna. Again, another Utsava, Janma Utsava, always Utsava, festival in Vrindavan, every day is a festival. Even Prabhupada used to say that if I had the means, every day I would conduct a festival. And Vrindavan and Vaikuntha and Goloka, that is the nature. Every day is a festival, every step is a dance, and every word is like a song. So, everybody has gathered and they want to celebrate Krishna's Janmotsava, Janmashtami. And they are very busy doing so many things, and Mother Yashoda took Krishna in her lap and fed him nice milk. And after feeding, she was just lifting the baby Krishna up and down, you know, sometimes we like to do that for children. And Krishna was enjoying this up and down movement, but then he wanted to really go even further higher up. But then his mother was lifting him only about 2-3 feet up above the ground. And then he became very heavy. And Mother Yashoda thought, what happened to my baby boy? Did some ghost get into him or something that he gotten so heavy? So she places him on the ground and she runs to get a Brahmana to see what's happened to him, to drive away some ghost or something that may have entered into him, because of which he's become so heavy. But Krishna knows that Trinavarta is about to come. So the third demon who we are going to discuss is Trinavarta, the whirlwind demon. So just when Mother Yashoda put Krishna down and she went to get the Brahmana, Trinavarta appears, who Kamsa has sent. Just like sometimes the uncle sends gifts to their nephew, Kamsa also kept sending so many gifts to Krishna. Demon after demon after demon. So this Trinavarta showed up and then he picked up, just like Putana, he was also very expert in killing the babies. He would eat the babies. And who was Trinavarta in his past life? He was a king, a Pandya king, a prominent one by the name Sahasra. And apt to his name, he had 1000 wives. And he would take bath nude along with all his 1000 wives in a pond, totally intoxicated. And one such day when Durvasa Muni was passing by, obviously when we see a holy saint, we have to offer obeisances and offer them a seat and all those things. At the least, somebody should be at least properly covered with clothes. And here the Sahasra was so intoxicated that he didn't even recognize Durvasa Muni. And Durvasa Muni, he is infamous for his temper. So he got angry and he cursed Sahasra, saying that you will become a demon in your next life. But as a benediction, because then Trinavarta, Sahasra, he came to his senses and apologized. So Durvasa Muni said, although you will become a demon in your next life, Krishna himself, after 10,000 years, come and become the cause of your liberation. So that is Trinavarta. He shows up in Vrindavan and he picks up baby Krishna. And because he's a whirlwind demon, he takes Krishna away. He is going higher and higher, 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 higher. And Krishna is absolutely enjoying this ride. And Trinavarta has also taken him so high up. And now Krishna thinks it's about time. And he holds his neck, especially this section, the throat section, and chokes him so hard that Trinavarta can barely breathe. And Trinavarta is like trying to scream. He cannot, far from screaming, he cannot even breathe. And he's trying to just let go of Krishna, push him from high up to low down. And but Krishna is like becoming so heavy now. And because of the weight, Trinavarta, who had taken Krishna so high, they're coming down. And as they're coming down, Krishna chokes him to death. And Trinavarta falls on the ground and ends his life. So this is how Krishna killed Trinavarta after enjoying a beautiful ride like a roller coaster. So what does this demon, the whirlwind demon Trinavarta, which anartha does he represent in us? Any guesses? Well, Trinavarta represents the anartha of ahankara, ego. So now, somebody can feel proud, aham, primarily because of four things. In fact, Kunti Maharani beautifully tells this in her prayers. Janma Aishwarya Shruti Shribi. Somebody could be proud of their janma, that I am born into such and such a family, my lineage is so great, I am part of this dynasty. That is one of the ahankara. Then Aishwarya, because of somebody's wealth, if somebody is very wealthy, they could become very proud. And then Shruti, because of somebody's knowledge, vitvat jnana, so much of knowledge, becoming extremely puffed up. And the fourth one is Shri, somebody who is beautiful, even they become puffed up. So now Trunavarta specifically represents the ahankara that comes from Shruti B. Shruti means knowledge. Vidvat ahankara is represented by Trunavarta. And this is actually a very dangerous, of the four, this is the most dangerous anartha. The most dangerous type of ahankara, I mean. Because the other three, like beauty, puffed up this thing, over a period of time, nobody has to do anything, just with time, the beauty will go away. And Janma also, it's not going to last that long. I mean, how much can you really boast about it and what can you do other than the past lineage part of it? And wealth also, at any moment, we've seen the richest of the people become paupers overnight. But this jnana, it is very dangerous because it's hardly even recognized the very person who is becoming puffed up because of this knowledge. So there are two types of fall downs that could happen. One is the sensual fall down and the other is the philosophical fall down. So when somebody has this ahankara because I want to enjoy more because of Janma, Shri or Aishwarya, they're wanting to enjoy so much material sense gratification, it's sensual fall down. But philosophical fall down, because of somebody's intelligence, getting to a point that I know it all. I don't have to sit and listen to somebody else in their classes. What does that person know? I know it all. Everybody else should be listening to me. All this is philosophical fall down. I mean, it's going to lead to philosophical fall down, intellectual ahankara. In fact, Srila Prabhupada, our spiritual master, out of his disciples, it's not like everybody were perfect, whoever took to Krishna consciousness. Some of them did have some fall downs. But we have seen that anytime it's a sensual fall down, Prabhupada was lenient enough, merciful enough to take them back into the movement, if they were willing to correct themselves. But anytime there was a philosophical deviation into impersonalism or so many different other things, Prabhupada would let them go and not take them back. And this philosophical deviation is such a thing that the person who is actually getting into it is not even aware of it. He or she is thinking that what I know is all in all and it's right. So they themselves don't recognize it, and if somebody else has to say it, then they don't have the humility to accept it. So it's very, very dangerous. And also, just like Trunavarta took Krishna high, 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 this vidvatta, ahankara, the knowledge, can also take somebody high, 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 but at a certain really high point, Krishna is going to immediately bring them down. It's going to be a major fall down. And it's going to be extremely hard to get back up on the feet again and then traverse the path of spirituality. So everybody who is very intellectually oriented, philosophical, inclinations are there, especially in the preaching field. We have to be very extremely cautious of this anartha represented by Trunavarta, the ahankara that comes from knowledge. So we should be extremely careful of this anartha. And how do we get rid of this anartha? By performing some humble services towards other devotees, towards other people. And never feeling like I don't have anything to learn from someone, whether it's a neophyte or a senior devotee, whether it's a man, male devotee or a female devotee, because Krishna can speak anything through anybody. It doesn't matter whether somebody is 30 years in the movement or 1 year in the movement, whether somebody is a male body, female body. If Krishna so chooses, he can choose to speak through anybody. So we should not get judgmental and have this prejudices that I'm going to only listen from these people and not these people, and never ever stop hearing from our spiritual master, the pure devotee. So constant shravanam has to happen, and being humble and always being mindful about this anartha, the ahankara that comes from knowledge. So in this video, we have talked about two important asuras, Shakatasura and Trinavarta. We understood what anarthas are represented by these two demons and how we can diligently work in removing these anarthas from our heart. So that's it for this video. But in the next part, part 3 of the demon series, we will get ready to kill some more demons. Until then, Hare Krishna.